Now let's derive the net resistance for three resistors connected in parallel. So the circuit diagram is like this. So when do we call that resistors are connected in parallel? If the two ends of the resistor is connected across the same potential source. If you look at this R1, the two ends are connected across the same source, R2 also same source, and R3 also across the same source. Then this combination is called parallel mode of connecting the resistors. Now here, if the battery draws a current I, this current comes here, but here there are three paths to go. So some current will pass through like this, I1, and this is I2, and then this is I3. Now here, the three currents, the sum of the three currents, I1 plus I2 plus I3 must be equal to the current drawn by the battery. So now this I1 will come here, and this I2, this is I3. Finally they combine, and then through the negative terminal only again I current will be entering it. Now I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to I. Here what is the beauty of this circuit is the potential difference across the first resistor, that is V, and here also V, and here also it is V only, because all the resistors are connected across the two terminals of the cell. Now according to Ohm's law, we can write V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. This is all equal to I. Now if you take V as common, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Now if you replace this entire circuit in such a way that we are connecting the same cell and we are connecting a resistor, we have to choose a resistor in such a way, it should also draw the current I from the cell. In that case, what we can write, V is equal to I times R. Now I is equal to V by R. Now we will replace this I here by V by R. So in this equation, the right side portion is V by R. So now if I write that one, V times 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 is equal to V by R. So you can cancel out this V, and then finally resultant resistance in parallel, if you consider that it is RP, where P is suffix representing parallel connection, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Remember, resistance controls the current. So if you want to increase the resistors are connected in series. If you want to decrease the resistors are connected in parallel. If you connect, suppose, 3 resistors, 5, 3 and 2, if you connect them in series, the resultant resistance will be 10 ohm. So 5, 3 and 2, 5 ohm, 3 ohm and 2 ohm. If they are connected, the resultant resistance is 10 ohm. If G is more than 5, more than 3, more than 2. But if these three are connected in parallel, 5, 3, 2 ohms, then 1 by RP is equal to 1 by 5, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2. Whereas the resultant, the LCM is 30, then here 5 6s are, 3 10s are, 2 15s are. So it's going to be 31 by 30. Therefore R in parallel is 30 by 31, which is less than 1. So which is less than 5, less than 3 and less than 2. So in parallel we always get the resultant resistance which is less than the number of individual resistors, and in series it is more than individual resistors.